According to McDonough, Main Street officials, the monthly Ladies Night Out program has become quite successful. This is a picture of Diane Edding, who won the April gift basket giveaway, along with McDonough Tourism Director Jennifer Price and Kathy Lacey from the Welcome Center. Ladies Night Out is the second Thursday of every month and encourages women to come out for eating and shopping with friends in the downtown area. The April event, according to city officials, had great weather and a very large crowd. And participating businesses provide items or gift cards each month as an added incentive for ladies to attend and register. Check out www.mcdonoughga.org for information on what is happening at the square and elsewhere in McDonough. One other recent event in McDonough was the St. Patty's Crawl, and the Main Street McDonough program sponsored the grand prize, which is a three-day weekend trip to Dahlonega with all accommodations included. The winner you see right here is McDonough resident Judy Bailey, and she received her prize from Main Street Director Linda Schenck. Bailey said that she and her husband have spent some time in Dahlonega and are very excited about the trip. And Schenck added that she was glad someone who loves Dahlonega was the winner. Flippin Elementary School students came out fairly early on May the 3rd. Parents and teachers and students showed up at 5:45 in the morning to greet Donna Lowry of 11 Live News and NBC's Education Nation tour bus. They got a check for $1,000 in the process. Here is the school principal, Dr. Tony Obernoff, receiving the check after the school won an online contest hosted by 11 Live through Facebook, and that earned the school the funds and the television exposure. The local channel paired the contest with parents, of course, NBC's Education Nation Tour Stop in Atlanta. Flippin Elementary was one of five Metro Atlanta schools recognized the first week of May. And as we said, the folks came out very, very early to make an appearance on TV and show their pride through songs and cheering and colorful signs. So congratulations to Flippin Elementary School for that. District 5 Commissioner Bruce Holmes will host his monthly town hall meeting Saturday, May the 26th at 9 a.m. at the Fairview Recreation Center. Now, originally, because the Memorial Day weekend, the meeting had been moved up to the third Saturday in May, but it has been rescheduled and it will be May the 26th. This month's town hall will focus on public safety, and the featured guest will be Henry County Police Chief Keith Nichols, who will present a biannual report on public safety and crime. The meeting is open to the public and everyone's encouraged to attend. The Fairview Recreation Center is on Austin Road in Stockbridge. Also on the northern end of the county, public safety officials are hosting the second annual Safety and Protection Night Tuesday, May the 29th from 5 to 8 p.m. And this will be in the Home Depot parking lot in Ellenwood. This is similar to National Night Out, and it's an evening designed to heighten crime and drug prevention awareness, generate support and participation in local anti-crime programs, and strengthen neighborhood spirit and emergency services community partnership. This event is free and open to the public. There'll be various displays by Henry County law enforcement, the fire department, and the 911 command center. McGruff is scheduled to make an appearance. There will be food and booths set up by local businesses along with music and a DJ. The Home Depot is on Fairview Road in Ellenwood. For SCB News, I'm Monroe Roark. It's time for this week's roundup of health scores from local restaurants. These are provided by the Environmental Health Office in McDonough. Take a look. Receive the restaurant scores before they even appear on this broadcast, go to my Facebook page. When you like that page, you'll get the scores the week before. You can see them on here, but you'll also be able to see this broadcast because there is a YouTube video every week of various segments of the program, and you'll find the links on the Facebook page as well. For SCB News, I'm Monroe Roark.